My name is Lina Roessler. The film is Bestsellers. Bestsellers is about a cranky old author who has one book left in him, that is, and then a young publisher who's needs one last book to save her publishing house. They come together on a crazy road trip, and together they discover a little bit more about themselves and perhaps that some things are more important than others. So.
Starting with our cantankerous author, can you talk about the perfect fit that Sir Michael Caine is for that role?
Michael is absolutely fabulous in this role, as is expected, and you couldn't ask for anything more. He really delved deep into the character and gave a lot of little subtle, the only things that Michael can do to really bring a depth to this character and an authenticity. I think what's unique about it is that we get to see him really sort of down and out. He has done that. I mean, look, he's had a brilliant career with many different roles, but this one you really get to see him vulnerable, down and out, alcohol, sort of really, and he has played that before, Educating Rita, but you get to see a sort of darker, messier side, but also with a real heart that that the man himself has as well. And Aubrey, again, is also exceptionally talented and more known for her comedic ability. But what was great for her in this role is that she really, again, brings like an authentic, emotional, subtle and sensitive character to the role of Lucy. And I think that's something we haven't seen a lot from Aubrey, so it was great. Yeah, I guess, I mean, it has been done in Lost in Translation. It's a good example, but I think what you're really talking about is men who are older and in a later stage of their lives, and then a younger woman. But what this story, at least in Bestsellers, it's, I call it a surrogate father-daughter love story. You know, they're not father-daughter, there's no romance in the story, but they become real kindred spirits, and I think that just shows that that's possible between obvious men and women, no matter what the age, and more to that, it's possible for everyone, really. I mean, we're all human, right? That's what brings us together.
We're here at Raindance, you're opening the festival. What does it mean for you to be a part of this celebration of independent storytelling?
It's really wonderful. It's a dream come true, and Michael receiving this award tonight as well, I think it's a really beautiful moment for us, for the film. Especially after COVID, it's a long time, it feels really great to come here and thank the festival very much for having us.
Of course, over the past couple of years, everyone has been asking themselves big questions, and a common one is why storytelling matters so much in our lives. Can you talk a little bit about what for you it means to be a storyteller and why stories are so important for you?
Absolutely. I think stories are important to us all, and it's how we make sense of ourselves, how we make sense of our place in the world, and how we put things together. They're just spokes in a wheel. We stitch it all together to try to find meaning in our lives, especially in times like this where, you know, the floor gives way underneath us. We don't know what's solid. We look to stories to kind of bring us together to find a meaning, and that's the point of life, right? Find a meaning in the meaning of it.
Are there any other stories that you are excited to be bringing in our direction looking to the future?
Absolutely. There are a few things on my plate, and we'll see which one gets cooked up and ready to serve first. So keep watching. I'll keep you posted.